我是刘嘉义，这是我们两个人生中第一次 vlog， 贡献给了
哈佛中国教育论坛。
今天的 vlog 呢，是我们 Early Childhood Education Panel 早期儿童教育分论坛预热活动的一部分。
我们这次分论坛的主题是早期社会情绪发展，也就是所谓的 Social Emotional Development。
今天我们会在哈佛大学随机采访学生、老师、路人，然后跟他们聊一聊他们人生中最初的记忆。这和社会情绪发展有什么关系呢？往下看。
想问你一下，就是你还记不记得你人生的早期，比如说小学之前，有没有什么比较深刻的记忆或者什么情景？
我最小的时候的记忆应该是在我姥姥家长大，然后在姥姥家一些场景是在看书啊、玩啊，然后跟那个时候的小伙伴一些交流。
那你就是当时的感受大概是什么样子？
那个时候的记忆给我的感觉就是很温馨、很暖，然后就被亲人包围着。但是我也有自己的空间，有自己的自由，然后会被管，所以就感觉是又温馨又自由。
那你就是之后的人生又还有没有过类似的？
就是一样的，好像没有一模一样的体验。对，但上学的时候，就是有一些好朋友圈子也会有这种感觉。
那你现在回想的话，就是你早期的最初的这个跟老师或者说小伙伴一起玩的这种体验，对你之后的人生可能会有什么样的影响？
我觉得是有影响的，就是这种愿意亲近人，然后与人为善，就是对人的感受的关注要高于对事情的关注，这样的习惯吧。
So at my primary school, after school, we were offered dancing lessons. Yeah, so it would be like Irish step dancing, ballet or ballet folklorico, and different kind of groups would come and teach us that. And that was really formative for me, and I did dance well after those classes.
Well, great. So how did you feel when you were in the dancing part?
Well, it made me, I guess, value like extracurriculars, or like made me excited to do that kind of thing, and it made me feel like my teachers valued us because we got to do things as well as like academic things in school. So
it's great. Well, in your later life, do you have any similar experience or feelings like that kind of excitement or being valued?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like because of that, I value and take fun things that are after the lesson, so yeah, we just want to go.
Doing it, realize that I'd forgotten.
Thank you for sharing with us. Have a good day.
Thanks. Early experience.
Yeah, I think one of the ones that I remember very clearly in kindergarten was I was in charge of like the table where all of the kids sat. It was like four of us at the table. And there was this one girl at our table who during nap time, she took a bottle of glue, she unscrewed and poured glue all over the table. And then for some reason told the teacher that I did it. And then I got in trouble because I was kind of the table captain. And I remember just being so angry at me, like, this is unfair. And that being just kind of like, but I also didn't want to, I didn't really believe in taking revenge or anything like that. Because I didn't really have like, I don't know, that's okay. I didn't really have the power to change anything about it. And so that very much was something where I was just like, I just don't like it when people lie. I'm like, people are unfairly abusive things. And that I think became part of my character too, is like when I saw that kind of injustice even on the playground, I was really quick to stand up for people because I knew how that felt to just be like picked on or just like, in a situation that was beyond your control. And I mean, now I'm in law school and, you know, I care about people who are in really dire economic straits or legal circumstances. Like even in the criminal justice system, you have people who are on death row for crimes they didn't commit. And I think I care about issues like that. And I can honestly tie it back to honestly something that happened to me as a child. Because I saw an authority figure,
right now I'm
a teacher
around,
who wasn't able to stand up for me when I needed her to. So I was like, you know what, I'll be that person. I'll be the person who stands for people, since I can't really count on us to do it for me. So, yeah.
影响了他对自己职业的规划，包括现在选择。
然
后还有那个
很漂亮的
我见过脸最小的小姐姐然后她那个童年在舞蹈班的一些很好的回忆让她非常重视就是学课程之外的事情就是学习以外的事情这个我觉得其实是一种对生活享受的就是享受生活的
享受生活
对对对
我觉得特别重要比如说现在大家学业都很忙或者也有工作啊然后包括学习啊这些事情要有压力很大的时候但是如果有这样童年的美好的回忆有快乐的被老师被老师欣赏被老师重视的感受那他现在也会去重视除了学习以外的生活
对而且他会有一种叫什么自我效能感、就是他是一个被重视
被重视
对
被 value
对是这样的所以其实你看其实小时候很多事情可能我们都忘了但那种场面那种情绪我们会一直都记在心里然后它会影响我们人生中很多很多重要的决定比如说像这种人生发展人生方向职业上的与人相处上面的等等等等
就我想起来一句话我之前在幼儿园实习的时候在他们墙上会贴一个标语然后那个标语就说的是People will not People will forget what you did, what you said, but they will never forget what you may not be.